Welcome back, everyone, to another dicondissectional production hosted by Deathstroke9. Today we're going to be reacting to Nazareth, Please Don't Judas Me, which is an interesting name for both the group and song, so I'm excited for this. Welcome to the channel if you're new here. My name is Daniel, aka Deathstroke9, and here we react to music. I try to figure out what the music and the lyrics mean to me personally. At the end of every video, we do research on the song to figure out, you know, what's going on. So, yeah. It's fun times for everybody. Now, I've never heard of the group Nazareth, but interesting name. So Nazareth seems to be maybe a biblical reference, and then the name of the song is literally Please Don't Judas Me. And Judas would also be a biblical reference. So, pretty interesting. Let's see what we've got. Link to the original video is going to be down below in the description, as always. And yeah, if you're new to the channel and you enjoy the content, consider subscribing. I try to make my videos a little bit unique compared to a lot of other reaction channels where I try to research the song at the end and I also give my own interpretation of what the song is. So anyway, I digress. Let's go. 3, 2, 1, Nazareth. This is, I guess, off the Hair of the Dog album. Okay, Hair of the Dog. Interesting. Let's go. Feels science fiction-y. Sound like Metallica for a second. Got the lyrics pulled up right over here. This is a patron request, by the way. I forgot to mention that. They've requested it a couple times. Taking a while. Ooh.
Please don't Judas me. Treat me as you like to be treated. Ugh. Please don't blacklist me. Leave me as you wish to find me.
Don't analyze me. Sorry, Nazareth. Has to be done. I've got a reputation to uphold. Plus, yeah, it's fun. So, yeah. Don't analyze me. Interesting. All right. I haven't heard enough to really have an opinion yet, so let's just keep going. Please Don't Judas Me by Nazareth. I really liked the very, it was slow and building, and then his voice was very, like, it was pretty aggressive. Very interesting. Let's go. 3, 2, 1.
Sacrifice me. Please don't Judas me.
Don't Judas me.
Please don't chastise me. Show me just one shred of kindness. Try to help.
Love the guitar.
Don't despise me. Categorize me. Please don't Judas me.
Ooh. Drums are good too. Pretty dramatic. You know, that background. Oh, that's awesome. The drums there are incredible. So I guess Judas me is kind of like betray me. That bass back there. This is very interesting. So it sounds like he's telling other someone not to betray him, but it also feels a little bit like, are the lyrics slightly like someone who's not very confident in themselves or paranoid about other people or someone who's been mistreated by too many people? So in the Bible, so Judas betrays, and that's another thing. He's saying, don't Judas me. Does that mean that he thinks he's the Christ? Or that he's, like, virtuous and they're trying to tell him he's not? So don't Judas me. Treat me like you'd like to be treated. A lot of kind of biblical references here. Don't blacklist me. Leave me as you'd wish to find me. That makes me think of, like, isn't that in the Boy Scouts and the Girl Scouts? You gotta leave it as you found it, right? Don't analyze me. Sacrifice me. Please don't Judas me. And he's saying please. He's trying to be polite. Please don't chastise me. Show me just one shred of kindness. Try to help me see. Guide me in my eyes of blindness. That's interesting. Don't despise me. Categorize me. Please don't Judas me. Please don't head shrink me. So what does it mean when you've got a swollen head, right? Big ego, I think. Maybe is that what he's talking about? Let's look it up. I'm actually kind of apprehensive to look this up. What is a head shrink? Oh, the shrinking head. Okay. Well, why is a psychiatrist called a shrink? I've actually always wondered that. It's a reference to the ritual practice of shrinking heads. Wow. The term shrink was adopted as a joking reference to psychotherapists in the 1960s. I've actually always wondered that. It's interesting. You learn something new every day. Anyway, I'm going to keep my original interpretation of, like, an ego and then, like, someone trying to burst your bubble. Prick the balloon. Don't disguise your innuendos. Let me just make sure I know what innuendo means, because a lot of times, doesn't that have slightly, like, sexual undertones? Or is that just the only place I've seen it? Yeah, typically a suggestive one, right? An elusive or oblique remark or hint. She's always making sly innuendos. So don't try to, like... So he says he's blinded. So he's saying, don't try to put me down in, like, a subtle way. Don't lie to me. I see the way the wind blows. Don't deface me, annihilate me. Please don't Judas me. All right. Before I continue, let's actually finish the song, because we're only halfway through. Let's keep going. 3, 2, 1. It's been very slow so far. I wonder if it's going to pick up. I like how the drums came in, and I really like the background noises. The guitar is really interesting. Yeah, it's very interesting so far. Cry for help. It's almost like he has been betrayed. It was almost like doom metal a little bit, very, not exactly, but tiny bit. Doom metal before doom metal, maybe. When did this come out? This says it was released on 1975, the 1st of January. Alrighty then. God's still going in the background there. Okay. That was Please Don't Judas Me. Let me see. Love the emotion in Dan McCafferty's vocals. Yes, definitely. Wore this album out, literally. My government needs to hear this song. My favorite Nazareth song. Okay, cool. The Ten Commandments of Any Friendship by Nazareth. Ah, okay. Love Nazareth. Alright, yeah. What a humbling song. Don't betray my trusted promise. There are so many people nowadays that are being Judas. Shout out to all the solo soul survivors out there. Keep pushing. Very good music. Don't bear false witness. Wow. You can't walk in another person's shoes, so don't frickin' judge. Just love. MFTF. Okay. Alrighty then. Let's see. Meaning. Let's see if perhaps there's anything on. Oh, apparently it's Metallica. Oh, wait. Who originally wrote it? I would assume Nazareth wrote it, but why is it saying that Metallica, maybe it was a cover, who knows? All right. It looks as though my favorite site, SongFacts, does not have this song. So we can check song meanings, see if they have any comments. I always got a lot out of this song. It always struck me as an intense moment in a growing relationship, one where the narrator lays down the conditions for things to continue. He's been burned before many times in many ways, so his list of conditions is both threatening and pleading and comes from an emotional core. The album Hair of the Dog is one of the absolute best in rock history. Okay, yeah, don't be prejudiced against people. Don't judge them. It's interesting that Judas is similar to judge. Did you hear that? Storm is rolling in. Tonight is going to be a fun night. All right. Well, that was Nazareth. Please Don't Judas Me. That was pretty cool. Yeah. The meaning was very interesting. There was a lot of emotion in his vocals. The music was very plodding on. I loved the solo at the end there. Some interesting instrumentation choices. I'd better upload this before the internet goes out. So, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate you guys. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing and stay tuned for more, hopefully, unless this storm knocks everything out. So, Deathstroke 9 out. See you guys soon. Great song.